Hello, my name is Jan Thielemann, and in this video I want to talk about broadcast messages. What is a broadcast message? It's a way to send messages to all the users in IdemPierre based on their role or their client, or one user in particular. And what you do to do this, you open the broadcast message window. I'm not sure if it's available also on Garden World. Yes, I'm logged in on this browser. I'm logged in as Garden Admin on Garden World. And you see he has the broadcast message too. And here I'm super user on system. And yeah, it will open this window here. Here you can enter your message. Hello world, for example. And then you provide a type. And immediate means that the message will pop up immediately. But if a user is not logged in, then he won't see this message. If you choose immediate end login, then the message will pop up immediately for logged in users. And users who are not logged in will see the message when they log in the next time. And then you have login. And this will show the message only when a user logs into the system after the message was sent. So I choose immediate here, and then you have to select a target. For example, you can send it to everybody in the system. You can send it to a certain role, to a certain user, or to the client. And I believe it uses the client you used to create this. So here I choose everybody because otherwise I won't see it on Garden World. Then I save this entry. Here in the translation tab, I have the possibility to translate my message to the messages and to the languages which are available in the system. So I use a standard system where only Spanish is enabled besides English, which is the base language. And yeah, it automatically creates this entry here. I don't need to change this. And now you can test the broadcast message. And this is what the message will look like for other users. And when you're satisfied with the look of the message, you can publish it. And then everybody will see it, also the sender who sent this. Now I can close this. And since this is immediate, I don't have to acknowledge this. So let's create another one. Let's say login. Target is again everybody. And now we have this frequency here. So I could show this just once. The user would be would log in and he would see the message, close the message, and then it will never be shown. Or I can choose until acknowledge. Then there's the little checkbox where the user has to acknowledge this message. Then we have until expiration, and then it will show this message every time the user logs in until a certain date is reached. And then you have a mix of expiration and acknowledge. So let's choose this and say it invalidates at 10 o'clock in the evening today. So now I hit, I save this and hit publish. Okay. And you see there's no message yet, but when I log out, and log in again, then you see the message. Let me drag this a little bit greater. So now here's this acknowledge checkbox. And if I log out and log in again, then the message is here again because I haven't checked this. So now I check it, close it, log out and log in again. And you see the message doesn't pop up again. Yeah, so that's basically how you can use this. By the way, here you have the message log. So which user did what to this message? And yeah, we at Evinos, we like the concept of broadcast messages because if you make changes to a productive system, you may want to warn the users that the system is going to be shut down. And yeah, do we have something like this here already? No, okay. Since we use OSGI in IDEM Pierre, there's rarely the need to restart the whole server. However, you can make custom documents, for example, via a plugin. And when you change something there, you may want to let the users know that there will be a change and that they should save their work and that a particular part of the application won't work on a certain date or so. So what we thought would be cool is a dashboard panel for the administrator, which is this panel here. It's open source. If you wonder where you can get it, go to the IDEM Pierre wiki, wiki.idempierre.org. In the English wiki, when you scroll down a little bit, there's this IDEM Pierre marketplace in the how-to section. And here you have a bunch of plugins which are open source. And here we have the broadcaster dashboard panel. And here's the source code. And you can simply clone this source code into your IDEM Pierre installation. And then you are able to run it. It comes with a 2-pack. And yeah, it automatically installs everything it needs. And yeah, unfortunately, our build server is currently not reachable. But soon you will have the installation path again. Then you can install it from our website. We are command line on your server, on your productive system, for example. And yeah, then you can use this dashboard panel. And what it does is, first of all, it shows you all the users which are either online or offline. And it shows you exactly the users you are allowed to see by your role settings. So here at Garden World, I see with my Garden Admin account, I only see Garden Admin and Garden User. And the super user also sees the web service user and some other users because he's the super user and he has access to more roles than the Garden Admin role. And there's also a new checkbox in the user roles, which you can use to make a user invisible in a given role. So for example, if I want to make Garden Admin invisible in the Garden Admin role, then I could check the is invisible in role checkbox for the user Garden Admin in the role Garden World Admin. Okay, that's to that. Now, when I want to send a message to a user, I can simply, wait, why is this user offline? Also, maybe I need to refresh my list. Or is he offline indeed? I'm not sure. Okay, however, let's send a message to Garden Admin. And there it is. And it automatically sends messages which you have to acknowledge. So let's acknowledge this. And if you only want to send it to online users, then you can tick this checkbox and then you don't have to acknowledge it. And what this does, it can send broadcast messages directly to a client, to a user, to an organization, by clicking on the organization name or by clicking on the role name, and then you can send it to a role. So let's log out and log in again and see if we can make Garden Admin online. Ah, yes, now it works. So now he's online. And if he logs out, then he should also log out on this panel, but it does not because, okay. So there seems to be a little error in the broadcasting of our messages. I think I have to fix this. But I believe you get the idea. This dashboard panel is maintained by the Evenos Consulting GmbH. And yeah, feel free to test it and report me your bugs so I can fix it. I believe this has something to do with the newer release I'm currently using. I developed this some weeks ago on an older release, and I believe in the meantime something changed. And yeah, now it's not working, but this shouldn't be hard to fix. So yeah, maybe you can give it a try and give me your feedback, either on the wiki page, which you can find in the in this little info box here, or in the Google groups, or directly in the comments under this video. Yeah, I hope this video helps, and if you like, feel free to leave a comment. And I hope to see you soon in the next video.